Subscribe to Femina and press the bell icon.
It is not possible to keep away from the affected persons.
I cannot just go up and close and be cozy with them.
They are giving us all this mental support to us.
Corona doesn't form a part of our discussions because it does dominate our entire work life.
I would definitely like to fast forward this 2020.
The best reward is when patient walks out from my wards or ICUs.
Hello, I'm Dr. Asha Bakshi.
Hi, I'm Dr. Farah Engle.
Hello friends, I'm Dr. Navneet.
Hello, I'm Dr. Apurva Satish Amarnath.
I'm Dr. Pradeep Mahajan.
I'm Dr. Bipin Chandra Bhamre. You are watching me on Femina In.
It is not possible to keep away from the affected person, especially if that is your patient and you have to really look after. But then we take all the precautions and as far as possible, we screen all our patients and try to keep the distance. But of course, you have to take some risk in life, and that risk we have to take.
Oh, it's very, very scary. Yes, because we are into this profession, and as you've said, we are close and upfront. So social distancing is nowhere in our profession when we are treating this patient. So in spite of knowing that after taking the best of precautions, there is a chance of us getting infected,
Strangely enough, when I least think about everything that surrounds the COVID-19 or the corona is when I'm actually working. I suppose this is a defense mechanism that I've created to cope with the situation.
The scare comes when you don't know much about the disease that you are dealing with.
Hugging is not a problem in my family because we are together, and as soon as we go home, we make sure that we disinfect our hands, change our clothes, and then sit at the dining table, talk to each other, and if we need a hug, then we do hug each other.
Yes, though my kids are grown up, still because of the lockdown, they are in the vicinity in the house. I sometimes feel like actually feeding my kids. So I take a step forward, but again thinking of me infecting them, you never know. I may be an asymptomatic carrier because of managing those COVID patients actively. I take two steps backwards. That is how we have to adjust, because there's always a risk of me transmitting infections to them.
As a family, we sit down to just discuss about the mundanity of life and things which we basically enjoy to do. Corona doesn't form a part of our discussions because it does dominate our entire work life at this point.
At the end of the day, when you go home with a tired and tired day, dealing with the current pandemic situation of the patients, we definitely feel to have a relaxation and hug of your partners. But there are times where we have to control our emotions, and a smile of confidence to each other gives a very powerful sense of hug. Thank you.
I feel very proud to be a doctor because at least I'm able to help someone. And anywhere I will go, I can help people, and in any circumstances, I can help people.
Personally, the ability to make a difference in a patient's life and is what makes me most proud about being a doctor. My specialty is that I help patients who are unable to conceive get pregnant. So bringing that ray of joy and happiness into a patient's world is what I really strive towards, and it's what really makes me happy.
There are very rare times where, as a professional or medical doctor, you get an opportunity to serve to the community, to the nation, where there are challenges. And I feel proud to be a medical doctor and helping out not only the community, to the nation, to deal with the current situation of pandemic.
On a lighter note, I expect myself to receive an award for the best doctor for doing the good work in this pandemic. But apart from that, seriously speaking, I like helping my patients. I like saving lives. That is my profession, and I am into this profession by my own choice. And helping saving lives itself is a huge award for me.
The best reward at this point will be that somebody finds 100% cure for COVID so that the whole world should breathe easily.
I would definitely like to fast forward this 2020 to 2021
The best reward is when patient walks out from my wards or ICUs with a great smile, which gives me a sense of gratitude and responsibility, the great happiness. That is my reward.